Okay, guys, next up, my partner has my back. So far, we've learned how to escape the lower body. And I prefer you guys always try to escape your lower body first. Why? The connection on the lower body is usually weakest, okay? The upper body connection, because Neil's arms are more coordinated, they're strong, they're tight. He has his chest behind my back. It's a much tighter control. It's also very difficult for me to work in this position with my hands. Like, I don't have much leverage in this position. So I generally want you guys to look to escape your lower half first. But it does sometimes occur, we have a great opportunity to escape the upper body, okay? The first thing I want to do when I'm trapped at the upper body is I want to attack the two knuckles here, okay? Mike, can you zoom in here? Look how I place my thumb on those two knuckles. This is very important, okay? This is the target area. These two knuckles are my target area. I want to place the pad of my thumb right on these two knuckles. From here, you see me, I'm in a baseball bat grip. I'm going to take my right thumb and place it over my left thumb, just like this. Now I have control over the end of the lever. The absolute end of the lever is these two knuckles. Okay, so right here, I start with a two-on-one control. I slide my thumb over those two knuckles. I take my right thumb, slide it over my own thumb, and I have two thumbs over those two knuckles. From here, I start going into a Braulio Estima type wrist lock. Look how I start to torque his wrist. When I torque his wrist, you can see his elbow is pointing away from me. This makes it very hard now for him to choke me, try to choke me. I'm at the absolute end of the lever, and I've placed torque on his arm. From here, because I have torque on the arm, it's very easy for me to pass his arm from one side of my head to the other. Extremely easy, okay? As long as I've torqued his arm, it's very, very easy. From here, I'm gonna trap his elbow and his wrist. From here, guys, it's very easy now for me to avoid the choke. There's no possible choke for my partner. From here, I'm gonna start to escape the lower body. We can absolutely do everything we did earlier in the video, okay? I'm 100% safe from the choke, and escaping my legs and hips is far easier here than if he had the seatbelt. Okay, because I've removed the seatbelt. It's really, really easy now for me to escape, okay? Let's troubleshoot a few little details here. We're doing our wrist lock. Whenever we control the kill arm, we never want to control the kill arm above the wrist. If I'm above the wrist in any way, if my partner's strong enough, he could choke me. He could just power through my grips and choke me, okay? It's not the case if I grab below the wrist. See, here's the wrist. If I grab below the wrist, doesn't matter how strong my partner is. If he tries to just simply power through, he cannot power through. I can control the head of the lever. Go ahead, power through. Okay, we're controlling the head of the snake. Go ahead, like Braulio Estima likes to say. If I control the head of the snake, the end of the lever, he cannot power through. Okay, I have tremendous leverage over him as long as I grab him below the wrist. Okay, so we're using that principle here when we're doing our escape. My partner has a nice tight seat belt. The kill arm is protected by the underhook. Okay, can you switch your hands? If his hands were in this configuration, I can easily just peel his thumb. Peel his thumb, start to wrist lock him, and do the same song and dance. Okay, but a trained opponent is gonna protect the kill arm by covering it with the underhook. Once this occurs, we put our quick two-on-one on the kill arm, and you'll notice I put my thumb right away on those two knuckles we talked about. Hold tight here, be as tight as you can. From here, I take my right thumb and I place it over my left thumb. Can you release just one thing? Notice my grip here. My left thumb is on those two knuckles, and my right thumb goes right on my left thumb. From here, I'm gonna start to torque. I'm gonna start to go into that wrist lock. Go ahead, hold as tight as you can, Neil. Here, I have a tremendous amount of leverage. You're gonna be shocked and surprised how easy it is for me to wrist lock him here. Once I start to wrist lock him here, I'm gonna be able to break his grip. Go ahead, hold as tight as you can, Neil. Look, I start to break his grip. I start to pass his head, his arm, from one side of my head to the other. It's gonna be incredibly easy, okay? From here, I grab his elbow, and now I start to escape the lower body. Guys, very important detail here. If I just try to break his grip, hold me tight here. Look, I cannot break his grip. If I try to pass his arm from one side to the other, like this, it's very difficult. Place your thumb on those two knuckles. Place your other thumb, your right thumb, on your left thumb. Now ask your partner, hold as tight as you can, Neil. And now create a wrist lock action on his right arm. You're gonna see, no matter how strong your partner is, you're gonna be able to break his grip. Neil, hold as tight as you can. Go ahead, hold as tight as you can. It's very easy to transfer his arm from one side of your head to the other. Once on the other side, I grab his elbow. And from here, I ask my partner, try to escape your right arm. Incredibly difficult. Why? I'm controlling that elbow of his. From here, it's gonna be really easy for me to use the techniques we saw earlier in the video. to escape my lower body. And now I've completely escaped. Guys, I know what you're thinking. Coach, it's really easy for you to do because you're like 100 times stronger than Neil. 100 times stronger than Neil. So it's so easy for you to do it. But look, even if I am 100 times stronger than Neil, even if Neil grabs me below the wrist, I can't power through. See, I'm trying to power through. I can't. Use your other hand. As long as he's grabbing me below the wrist, I cannot power through. Can you grab me at the forearm? Look, here. I start to choke him. Can you use your left arm? Look, use both arms. Look, see? A bigger, stronger guy can wrap his arm around your neck and choke you. Always grab below the wrist. Get that thumb on those two knuckles. Okay, let's see here. I'm going to grab my kill arm tight. Neil's going to put that thumb on those two knuckles. Now slide your right thumb over your left thumb. Now look, I'm going to hold as tight as I can. Go ahead, Neil. Because he's doing a wrist lock, he's breaking my wrist. Go ahead, pass it. I'm trying to resist him 100%. That was 100% resistance. I couldn't stop him. Now he's going to grab my elbow. Look, he trapped my elbow. If I try to free my arm, it's incredibly difficult. Even if we're in a MMA match or a no-gi match, it's very, very robust, this grip. Very hard for me to slip my right arm out. Now Neil has an easy time now doing any of the escapes we did earlier. Very easy time because I cannot connect my chest to his back. Okay. Guys, one more time. I'm here like this. I'm tight, super tight. He's grabbed my hand at the end of the lever. He has two hands on the kill arm. Now he's going to start to go through that wrist lock. Go ahead. I'm resisting 100%. Very difficult thing for me to do. Okay, even with 100% resistance, I wasn't able to stop him from wrist locking me, breaking my grip, and passing the arm to the other side. Okay, let's give it a try.